Papa doesn't speak fluently. Skandamata, she has not started speaking. Any ordinary person will be very worried. She's not started speaking. I said, hey, relax. Kumara Gurubara did not speak. Not that he was dumb or deaf. No. He was just waiting for Subramanya to initiate so he can start straight singing. Same way Papa is just waiting. She will start straight conducting satsangs and initiations. She is just waiting to come and be with me in Kailasa. She will straight sit next to me in the Sarvajna Pita and start taking classes. Giving satsangs. Understand? A binary logic person can never understand what I am talking. Anyhow, when she does it, you guys will understand. There was a great saint, Kumara Gurubara. He did not speak for quite a long time. I think at least some 7-8 years. They took him to Tiruchendur Subramanya Swami temple. He just started singing directly, that's all. on Subramanya. There are many references in Hindu tradition for this kind of genius happenings. Papa doesn't speak. Not because she has something less or she is not capable. No, she is capable of too much. So she doesn't want to speak ordinary, small, small, stupid things. She says, I'll speak when I need to speak. When Ammayappan says, I'll speak what I need to speak. Otherwise, she's too sharp. Everything happening around her, she knows. You can't control her. But she doesn't speak. Skanda. Literally Skanda. Subramanya. Hastamalaka also did not speak until Shankaracharya came and initiated. So we have a lot of references.